Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind. I'm the RPG Chick, Amethyst Lutatari, now heading towards the southwest section of Baldur's Gate.
Alright.
Burp. Where we've been told the Flaming Fist headquarters is, and apparently might just be the roughest section of Baldur's Gate, other than, like, sewers or something like that.
You said something?
No, not yet. Got commoners and stuff. Tell us to speak up.
All right.
Or someone to speak up.
You're a long-tongued lout, ain't you?
Nothing new as far as dialogue so far.
Hello.
You're a long-tongued lout, ain't you?
Hey, friend. Good to meet a fine sod such as yourself.
Aye, thank you.
Life's been getting prickly on me, ours.
I'm not fat, I'm big-boned. Enormously boned, actually. Fantastically huge bones, the likes of which have never before been seen on creatures without a trunk or a blowhole. Okay.
Hello.
History of Durpar and Var the Golden. I have that book. I've read that book.
You wanna fight me? Oh, come on, you wanna fight?
Mama said not to talk to ventures. They're all loopy, she said.
Ooh, you smell.
You don't smell much better, kid. Alright, so I guess we can't go in there. What's this? Potion shop. Sweet. $33 gold. I think these ones out here are fine. Take from? Because they're not in anybody's house. At least. That's what I think.
Hello.
Need something, stranger.
Salutations. Can I assist you?
Yep, I'm not reading that out loud because we've already seen that many times. Some more than others, but yeah.
Hey, friend. Good to meet a fine sod.
Hello, pal.
What's your tale?
Now we've been to the splurging sturgeon. 28 gold. Alright, is this place? This place is Ye Old Inn.
Bunch of chumps! What the hell do you think you was doing?
I think we're trying to go in the old inn, but I'm having trouble getting... Wait. Oh! What's going on here? Oh. Commoners killing green slimes. Or trying to, anyway. Let's try to save some commoners, I guess.
Tempest, give us victory!
The bartender says, leave this place! Ugh! There'd be green slimes rising from the cellars. Flee while you still can! We'll try to save you, sir. Take care of this one.
What? Yes?
You took care of all of them. Is the bartender dead? I think the bartender's dead.
Sure.
Unless he ran away.
You're a long-tongued lout, ain't you?
Whoa. One moment the barkeep was talking to the mage Ramazeth, then all of a sudden he's flaming mad. He summoned up all those slime creatures. Hideous things they were. What are you talking about? Ramazeth was flaming mad? Because we killed Ramazeth a few hours ago.
You're a long-tongued lout, ain't you?
I think eventually they killed the barkeep, which then we can't stay here, right? Where are you going? You can't get around us.
Such menial tasks.
15 gold. The stairs are closed.
All right.
We definitely took care of that Ramazeth. Alright, let's hang out over here.
Alright, alright.
Well, that was interesting. Is anything like the last one? The last one had something in it, and all the others are empty. Oh, now they're all empty. Alright, never mind. Oh well.
Why me?
Are you the new bartender?
Sure.
I just got 3 commoners. Thought there was 2, but yeah. Well, so much for ye old inn. You guys need a new bartender. I guess I did my best.
Why me?
General store is here. I wonder what vile perfidy we'll find going on in here. Storekeep and commoners.
Hi, friend.
Hey, Angelo's heroes from down south. You guys did real good whooping those bandits' asses. I always wanted to be an adventurer, but you know how things work out. Good luck to all of you. Yeah, I read that one.
My hubby didn't want me talking to no strangers.
We've taken care of Gorak. Guess she hasn't heard the news.
Hello?
Gorak is now a Gorak of the Well. There's some shadows here. Oh,
what's
that?
Your tale?
Leave me be. I just want to make sure there was no stairs or something down. That was weird.
Bunch of chumps.
Welcome to my
what
uncle's
the hell
establishment.
Do you think you was doing?
Welcome to my shop. You're free to look about as you wish, but do try not to break anything. I shall proceed with due care and attention. What do you have to show me? Here's the stuff. See if he'll buy any of our stuff. Yeah, we don't need any of this stuff, actually. Keeping these mage robes just in case. probably does not buy scrolls. Yeah. Okay. You won't buy anything we want to sell. I don't have much to sell anyway, so. Okay, so that's that. We skip the potion shop.
Sure.
Let's head back there. Always use some potions. There we go. Can't see the doors when it's on this side. Hello?
Sure.
Welcome to my humble establishment.
Please browse and take your time. I've no wish to rush a potential new customer. Let's see what you have then. Do we need some of those? 19 isn't that great. The potions of defense, really, really good. Armor class 0. Potion of healing, 9 hit points. We need a better healing potion. That's what we need. So what's the difference in here? Potion of healing here. Elixir of health. Oh, it's another extra hit point and cures poison and disease. Cold resistance. And this potion of healing is 9. I don't know what the difference is between, besides colors. Potion of magic protection, magic resistance. Yeah. These are worth a lot. Magic shielding. That's magical, non-physical damage. Master Thievery. Potion of regeneration, really. Regenerate 2 hit points per round for 3 turns. Wow, 3 turns. That's 30 rounds. Is it that effective though? I mean, for a long combat, I guess. It's just only 2 hit points. Let's get 2. Insight, wisdom 18. Okay. Alright, done. I don't suppose he buys scrolls. Just making sure, no. Just gonna store these away for now. So we might have need of them. I just can't see in that one corner. Just want to make sure there's like no stairs down to another level or something. Good day.
All right.
There's like a third building here. Bega and Kamina.
Bother and bother, never a calm spot.
Alms! Alms for the poor!
What do you need? Hello.
Okay, let's try in here. 7 Suns. What is 7 Suns? We have something about 7 Suns. The 7 Suns. Scar has hired us to investigate strange goings-on in the 7 Suns compound in the southwest section of the city. Once we have completed our investigation, we are to report to him at the Flaming Fist Barracks, which are located just west of the Seven Suns building. Alright, so I guess we're doing this.
Yes?
A merchant says, what can I do for you? We wanted a tour. Unfortunately, I cannot grant any of your desires, so could you kindly leave? Not until we get to see Jasso. I don't know where he is. He's been missing ever since everything went strange. I've seen of some of the other merchants change faces when they thought I wasn't looking. Yes, you heard me right. They change faces. Some sort of shapeshifters have infiltrated the Seven Suns. If I were you, I'd get out of here while there's still time. That's what I'm planning to do. Oh. A frightened merchant inside the Seven Suns building says the Seven Suns has been infiltrated by shapeshifters. Well, this could be interesting. I wonder if these people are shapeshifters.
All right.
Leave us alone, will you? Nothing for you here.
So you've come to visit the Seven Suns, have you? Yes, I've got your face now, but not your name. You've got my face, meaning you can literally change to look like me? Or Kagan? Fulio Displacius, destroyer of the Seven Suns rag. We have the Party of Sapphire, though I don't know why it might interest you. Yes, indeed. How interesting. And what are these people about you? Do they know you well? I'm not here to bare my soul before a merchant. If you wish silence, then we ask the same of you. Bother us not. What do you sell?
Leave us alone, will you? Nothing for you here.
Okay. They want to know about us so that they can... you know, take our place, I guess. Merchant here as well.
Why me?
Leave us alone, will you? Nothing for you here.
They all ask the same question.
Leave us alone, will you? Nothing for you here.
Mm-hmm. Huh. Well, unless I'm missing something, there's nowhere else to go. Are we just reporting back with the news that the one merchant gave us?
Sure. All right.
Oh, is another way? Is that another way out?
Sure.
Oh. Well, there's Jasso.
Sure.
Oh, there's someone. Oh, I didn't even see that. Okay. Well, I would like to get away from that. God. Ow.
Vita mortis
One more.
If Tempus wills it.
Tempus does. Jasso.
Come to torment me some more, you shape-shifting bastards.
Well, you'll get naught from me this day, nor a cry of pain nor the knowledge in my noggin. Get away from me, shapeshifter scum. Haha, we've come to torture you. We're not the shapeshifter you speak of. We're friends, sent by Scar to see what's been going on, what's going wrong here at the Seven Suns. Who are you? You know Scar. I'm Jasso, a friend of his, and the owner of the Seven Suns. You have to help me get out of here. It's good that we found you. Now we can find out what's been going on here. Before we take you anywhere, could you tell us what's been going on? These creatures, the shapeshifters, started infiltrating the Seven Suns some months ago. They must have started with some of the less important members of my coster. Eventually they captured me, and their leader took my face. They've been keeping me alive in order to gain information that they need through torture. I don't know what their purpose is, but they have been running my business very poorly. All of you will be well rewarded for rescuing me. When you meet Scar again, he will give you my reward. Must be off now, as there is much of the monster's work to be undone. I assume you've dealt with the other monsters upstairs. If you haven't, I'll get the Flaming Fist to clear out the rest. It'll probably be weeks before we can clean out their stench. No, they just talk to us like merchants. We learned from Jasso that a group of shape-shifting creatures has taken over the Seven Suns trading coster. Should we follow him to see what...
Sure.
Ah. Yeah, we'll take care of the monsters, all right. Let's throw a chromatic orb and a Melf's acid arrow. You even need to use that. Yeah, we'll take care of the one up here, right? Just one.
All right.
Why me?
All right. And I.
Die, yells. No need for the Flaming Fist. We'll take care of this. One more. Oh, I thought there was one back here. Never mind. They're all dead. Hopefully they get a bonus for taking care of these guys for them.
Why me?
Let's see what else is down there. I checked
why
this.
Why me?
Alright. And in here could be some kind of weapons. Ooh. Some kind of magical spear. We'll leave the rest. You know what?
Hey, how are things going?
Make sure there's no trap. Ooh, nice! 368 gold, a Flame Dance Ring, a Chrysoberyl Gem, and a Shandon Gem. Excellent. Two drawers. Okay, we got some protection scrolls, some kind of wand, and a Potion of Hill Giant Strength. That's the 19 one, the one I passed up buying at the potion shop. Pretty awesome. I doubt I can... just... bring these over first. Damn it. Yeah, I don't know what the wand is. And I'm probably not gonna know what these are. Oh yeah, she's gonna hold on to that. Yeah, unknown.
Go pester someone else.
Never.
Why me?
Was that it? We can't get in these rooms. We can't even open the doors. Okay. Well, that was interesting.
Why me?
Things sound really spooky when they die.
Salutations.
Oh. Leola Axehand says, "You there! Before you go causing any more trouble, I must insist that you seek an audience with Scar, if you haven't already." What would he have to say to me? Why do I need him? I do not presume to say you need assistance. I merely meant to point you in a helpful direction. Making waves within Baldur's Gate without the sanction of the Flaming Fist can only lead to trouble for all concerned. Scar awaits you at the Flaming Fist headquarters in the southwest quadrant of the city. Okay. Well, we will go there eventually.
Right.
First, we're going to explore the rest of this city. I mean, he told us to take care of that.
Yeah.
I heard that the Merchants League is having a lot of trouble. Seems that the three owners are squabbling about how to run the place. The Iron Throne's been taking advantage of that situation. If things continue as they are, the Throne soon won't have any competition. Kind of strange, considering they only moved into the city a couple years back. Indeed. So we've seen a good amount of this city already.
What do you need?
I heard that the Omnians and Tarim are the duffers who've been causing all this trouble lately. We ought to invade Om and show them how we treat treacherous scum such as them.
I lost my dolly.
I saw we.
Yeah?
You funny looking.
So is your Uncle Sue. And you, sir?
Hello, pal.
Same thing we've seen. Oh, that's interesting. Aldeth Sashenstar. Sounds vaguely familiar.
You there! Identify yourselves!
It is so pleasant to see your faces once again. Wait, you just said to identify ourselves, but you seem to know who we are. Don't you recognize me? It is I, Aldeth Sashenstar. I am so glad to have met you, especially at a time like this. I need to speak with you privately. Will you listen to what I have to say? Of course, we'll listen. Thank you so much, my friends. This should suffice for privacy. I'm sorry for all this hiding and skulking, but there are dire events afoot. You know that I am one of the principal shop shareholders of the Merchants League. Well, I share ownership of the company with two others, Erlentree and Zorl Miar, two very distinguished gentlemen. When I returned from my hunting trip, thanks to you, I might add, I found that my two partners had undergone some profound changes, nothing physical or overt, but something far more sinister. Well, go on. What's so sinister, shape-changers? It's as if my partners had become wholly different people while I was gone. They almost take an active interest in squandering our company's resources on frivolous and stupid ideas. If they continue on this course, the company will be in shambles, but in but a few weeks. I know that you have already helped me once, but I ask for your assistance again. I have no other recourse. What do you want us to do? Come into the Merchants League estate with me. I'll explain that you are old friends of mine, and we'll quarter all of you in the guest chambers. Hopefully you don't mean draw and quarter me. From there, please investigate my partners, perhaps using magic or any of the other skills you possess. Learn as much as you can during your visit, and then report back to me after you're done. It should only take a couple of days. Doesn't sound like too hard of a job. Why don't you do it yourself? Because I know you. I thought you were a man of nobility. I must have been mistaken. Well, there is little I can do but try to find someone who's up to the task. I'll be here some while more. So if you deign to change your mind, speak to me again. I was just asking. I wasn't denying to help you. Sounds like an easy job. We'll do it, I guess. Then just follow me into the Merchants League estate. You may begin the investigation as soon as you get inside. I shall be waiting for any reports of your progress on the second floor. Investigating the Merchants League estate. Aldeth Sashenstar has asked me to investigate the unusual events at the Merchants League estate. Aldeth awaits my report on the second floor. So I guess it's in there. More doppelgangers, I'm sure. He says it's going to take a couple days? What the hell is with that? Why would it be a couple days? Erlen Tree and Merchants and Guards. Sleepy, huh? Greetings, sir. I hope your stay at the Merchants League estate is profitable. Got sleepy guards.
This group shows promise exceptional.
Why, thank you. Who's Erlen Tree? Is he one of the ones?
So, these are the guests you've been talking about, Aldeth.
I think Aldeth's upstairs, isn't he? Greetings, house guests. I must assume that you are the friends that have had Aldeth so excited. I must introduce myself. I am Erlen Tree, one of Aldeth's partners in business. I've come to announce that the company is celebrating the anniversary of Aldeth's stay with us. I would like you to join for the festivities. There should be some interesting surprises. I'm sure we'll be there. The party is set to take place on the third floor. If you go up there, I'll meet you soon after. Erlen Tree, one of the owners of the Merchants League, invited us to Aldeth's anniversary party on the third floor. That's when you all attack us, I'm sure. I thought there was a person there. There's a merchant here.
I've got the best prices this side of Cormyr.
Anything I can help you with? Oh yes, so you're those friends of Aldeth's. I'd love to get to know you better, but I'm awfully busy. Yes, assuming the form of others. It's gotta be quite busy work indeed.
I've got the best prices this side of Cormyr.
Looks like they all say the same exact thing. Well rehearsed.
I've got the best prices this side of Cormyr.
Best prices this side of Cormyr. Any other doors or anything? Or we just go up? Because that one door in the Seven Suns, I didn't see it at first. I guess we're just going up. Zol, Brandalar, and there's Aldeth himself.
All right.
Hail, Zorl.
Hello. Nice to make the acquaintance of such a cultured personage.
Greetings. You are all new faces. I am Zorl, and you must be Aldeth's childhood friends? Yeah, we've been friends since we were kids. So were you good friends with Dabron as well? Dabron? You don't remember. Aldeth's brother. Most interesting. I'm a busy man with a company to run. Please don't disturb me. Oh, geez, fill me in, will ya? And tell me about your brother.
What do you need?
Hold. I'm Commander Brandalar. I lead the Household Guard. You must be the people Aldeth brought back with him, his so-called childhood friends. That likely story might have hoodwinked some of the others, but I've known Aldeth since he was a kid, and none of you ring any bells. That's because we're all older now. I don't like liars, but I'll give you another chance. Perhaps you're suspicious of me, but I've known Aldeth much longer than you have. Now, who are you? I don't think pursuing down this path is going to work. But he said his friends were acting different. Not this guy, the head of the guard. Hopefully Zorn or whatever his name doesn't... What's his name? Zorl? Hopefully Zorl doesn't overhear. Okay, you've cracked our disguise. We're actually investigators hired on to learn as much as possible about Aldeth's business partners. He seems to think that they've gone mad. I'm glad you've been honest with me. To tell you the truth, I've been somewhat suspicious of my older other employers as well. They haven't been themselves, and they seem to have a completely callous outlook on the future of their business. I'd almost have to say that Erlentree and Zorl aren't who they say they are, or they've had their minds taken over, or some other rot. Unfortunately, there's nothing I can do, because they're my employers. I might be able to turn a blind eye if you were to investigate what they've been doing. If you can find some hard proof that this exposes, or that exposes what's been happening, I might be able to do something about this whole mess. What do you say? Sure, we might as well work together. If you find anything, come back and see me immediately.